Well, here I am with another story. This was inspired by a tree on the Piney River, a huge old sycamore tree that I'd heard a little story about, and I had some experiences by that tree myself, and I did a little bit of weaving of what I'd heard and what I experienced. And so this will come to you as the sycamore. And here is the old story. This majestic old tree has been rooted here on a bend of the Piney River for centuries. And though it leans out over an eroding bank, it holds the earth firmly while it reaches high into the big sky. Not so long ago, a tired cowboy hunkered down in the lap of this giant, back to its gray trunk, with his melancholia, a bottle of bourbon, and a revolver. And in the end, the last shot was not a libation. Sometimes you follow the dipping honeysuckle trail to loll in the cool spring waters. Your eyes are on the lookout for copperheads as you walk, but you avoid the sycamore even more. It appears to cast dark shadows on the cloudiest of days, as troubled spirits linger with no place to go. And here's the new story. It would take three long-limbed humans holding hands to encircle this old friend. You know this because you have witnessed the huggers. Once you placed your hands on its trunk and closed your eyes, and you saw so much. The tree was in its youth, and so were the Chickasaw boys that startled you with their laughter. And in your vision, they hung their bows on its branches, and stripping naked, ran down into the waiting waters. It was then that you realized what bright memories also abound within the rings of this towering elder. Days later, you would find a little red jasper arrowhead in the nearby loam of a freshly tilled garden. Holding it tightly in your hand, you again felt the presence of those young boys from long ago and smiled at the gift given by ancient hand. In recent years, a bald eagle occasionally stops by to roost in the sycamore's uppermost branches as it journeys up and down the piney. And perhaps it stops to bring a waiting spirit home.